वी जनार्दन रेड्डी. इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड इट्स डेफिनेशन. व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, हाउ इट इज मेजर्ड, व्हाट आर इट्स यूनिट्स, व्हाट इज द फार्मूला टू फाइंड द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इन ए सर्क्यूट एंड व्हाट इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट इज यूज्ड टू मेजर इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इन ए circuit, that we are going to learn in this video. Okay, see here is a conductor in which there are free electrons, and these free electrons are moving randomly throughout the conductor. If we imagine a cross sectional area here, the number of electrons crossing this cross sectional area from left to right are equal to the number of electrons crossing from right to left in 1 second, isn't it? That means the net charge flowing either from left to right or from right to left is zero. So in this conductor there is no current because all the free electrons are moving randomly. Suppose if the two ends of this conductor is connected to a battery, then all the electrons, free electrons inside the conductor will move in a systematic order, isn't it? So here there is no current in this conductor. You can see here all these electrons are moving randomly throughout the conductor, isn't it? Now I am going to connect a battery to the two ends of this conductor. Then what will happen? Let us see. So this one is the conductor we have seen so far. I have bent in this way, and there are so many free electrons inside the conductor. Just now I have shown you how these free electrons are moving randomly. Now I am going to connect the two ends of this conductor to a battery. Then what will happen? Let us see here. Here, all the free electrons inside the conductor will move in a systematic order. So the ordered motion of free electrons in the conductor is called electric current. Read. So all the free electrons are moving away from the negative terminal of the battery and entering into the positive terminal of the battery. That means the positive terminal of the battery attracts free electrons in the conductor, and the negative terminal of the battery repels the electrons in the conductor. Hence, all the free electrons in the conductor will move in ordered motion. So current is nothing but the ordered motion of charges. Here the ordered motion of electrons, isn't it? So here the number of electrons taken by the positive terminal of the battery are equal to the number of electrons given by the negative terminal of the battery. Great. So this end is collecting and this end is again giving. So here all the electrons are moving in systematic order. Now there is a current in the wire. Then how do we measure this current? How do we define it? Imagine that here is a cross sectional area. There is a cross sectional area I am going to place now. isn't it? So this is the cross sectional area. Then how much charge is flowing from left to right here in this case? How much charge is crossing this cross sectional area in t interval of time? Otherwise, the amount of charge crossing through this cross sectional area in 1 second is called electric current. Isn't it? You see here how these charges, electrons are crossing this cross sectional area. That means there is a net flow of charge from one end of the conductor to the other end. Then the amount of charge crossing through this cross sectional area in 1 second is called electric current. Imagine that Q charge is passing through this cross sectional area in T seconds of time. Isn't it? That means Q charge is crossing this cross sectional area during the time interval T. Then current, electric current equal to charge by time. How much charge is crossing through this cross sectional area? Let us say it is Q divided by time interval T. That is, during the time interval T, Q charge has crossed this cross sectional area. Then current I equal to Q by T. Okay. So here you can define definition of electric current. I am going to write. Just now I have shown you this cross sectional area. The amount of charge crossing any cross section of the conductor in 1 second is called electric current. It is denoted by I. That means this is the cross sectional area, and through this cross sectional area, let us say that Q charge is crossing from one end of the conductor to the other end. It is moving like this. Just now I have shown you. Okay, see here. Let Q be the charge crossing any cross section of the conductor in a time interval T. Say this is the cross section. And through this cross section, let us say that Q charge is passing from left to right in the time interval T. Then amount of charge crossing through that cross section in 1 second is Q by T. In T seconds, Q charge is crossing. Then in 1 second, how much charge passes through this cross sectional area? It is Q by T. Okay, so electric current, this is the formula. Electric current equal to electric charge by time interval. During the time interval T, Q charge has crossed this cross sectional area. That's why I equal to Q by T. Isn't it? So here I is the electric current, Q is the electric charge, and T is the time interval. You can place the cross section at anywhere. You can imagine that cross section anywhere along the wire. Okay. And the SI unit of electric current is ampere and denoted by A. Ampere is the name of the scientist, and this unit has been derived on his name, in the honor of his name. Isn't it? It is named after his name. So the SI unit of electric current is ampere and denoted by A. 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb by 1 second. Coulomb is also name of the scientist. Okay, so 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb by 1 second. That means if in 1 second time, if 1 coulomb charges crosses through any cross sectional area of the conductor, then the current in that conductor is said to be 1 ampere. 1 A equal to 1 C by second, 1 coulomb per second. Then 1 coulomb equal to how many electrons? 1 coulomb charge equal to the charge on these many electrons is called 1 coulomb charge. 6.625 × 10⁸ electrons. That means 1 coulomb charge has crossed through the cross sectional area, means these many electrons should cross in 1 second. Then we can say that 1 coulomb charge has crossed the cross sectional area. So 1 coulomb equal to these many electrons. That means the charge on these many electrons is equal to 1 coulomb. Okay, and electric current is measured by using an instrument called ammeter. It always connected in series to the circuit. How ammeter is connected in series later I will show you. So here is the ammeter. Ammeter measures the current directly in amperes when it is connected in series in a circuit. Okay, so ammeter is the instrument which is used to measure the current in amperes. Okay, so this is the ammeter. Thank you.